I will be adding half cup of water in this bowl and 1 teaspoon of salt. Dissolving the salt well, I will keep this bowl aside. I will also heat oil in a wok or a skillet. And now I will be showing you to peel the bananas. Now this is actually called kacche kele or plantain. So these are actually like raw bananas. So first, the most important thing is to peel this plantain really well. You do not want any skin of the plantain on there. So I will be taking a mandolin, and once this oil is hot, I'm going to check it with one slice of the plantain. So this is looks like heated. So now I'm going to just use the mandolin and very thin slice the bananas directly into the oil. So this oil is not extremely hot, but it is on medium heat. So they can fry well on this heat. Now I will be adding that salted mixture on top of this plantain slices. Just nearly 1 to 2 teaspoons. You do not need it too much. Once your plantain starts changing color, you can remove one of the plantain slice and check whether it has cooked or not. It should be crispy. So once that is done, if you can see my plantains, they have start changing color. So I'm going to remove it. Just make sure not to put your plantain slices on an absorbent paper, because we need little bit of that oil for spicing. So I'm going to empty this, and now I'll show you the longer ones. So this is also one of the ways you can slice your plantains. Then again, we will follow the same procedure here. When you are not following Ekadashi, at that time you can use some powdered spices and also turmeric in it, like the powdered turmeric. You can already see how my plantains, they already look crispy. So I will be frying like this all the remaining batches of the plantains and putting them in a bowl together. The process of adding the salted water on top of the plantains helps the plantain to absorb it well, and it doesn't get too salty. So here I have freshly grounded black pepper, which I am sprinkling on top of it. And now what I'll be doing is tossing it well and then putting it in a serving bowl, placing a tulsi leaf and offering it at the lotus feet of Shri Krishna. This makes our offering complete. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.